Among all the different ways to create PBR materials, the technique that I'm about to show you in this video can help you speed up the process and enable you to create PBR materials from real-life surfaces just by using your iPhone or iPad. Physically based render materials are fundamental in creating realistic looking objects in computer graphics. They work by simulating how light interacts with surfaces in the real world, resulting in more accurate and lifelike visuals. They are typically defined by a combination of texture maps, each controlling a specific aspect of how light interacts with the surface. So commonly you will have maps such as base color, roughness, height of displacement, normal and ambient occlusion. There are a few methods that allow you to create PBR materials, including procedural generation, which will allow you to create the entire set of texture maps, and photogrammetry, which will provide you with a 3D mesh and a diffuse map as a starting ground to construct the other maps. In a similar way as photogrammetry, the Lidar scanning technology allows you to create 3D meshes from capturing surfaces in the real world and create PBR tileable texture maps, saving you from having to merge pictures as required by photogrammetry. One app that I found to give good results for this purpose is Scaniverse, which is entirely free. As for photogrammetry, you will have to be cautious of the lighting conditions around your subject. If outdoors, overcast days are always preferred, as you won't have strong lights baked into the final mesh. Once you've managed to capture a good portion of the surface that you want to obtain, you can export that as an OBJ and import that to Blender, where we can create the low poly plane that we'll use to bake the textures onto and make them tileable. Align the subdivided plane with the mesh from your 3D scan and apply a shrink wrap modifier projecting only one axis, so that the edges of your plane will keep the original square shape as the 01 UV space. Then export the low poly plane as an FBX file. And the next step is to bake the textures of the scan result onto the low poly plane in Substance Designer. At this stage, we are able to generate also the displacement map, a normal map, and an ambient occlusion map. Once you have your textures baked, you can move on to Substance Painter, where you can fix the edges and make the maps seamlessly tileable. Create a new fill layer and add the textures you baked from Substance Designer. Then add a paint layer and make it pass through on all maps. so that all changes that we make will apply consistently on all maps. To make the seams stand out so you can work on them, offset the material textures by half measure. One of the main issues with photogrammetry and 3D scanning is that both techniques will allow you to achieve only a diffuse map with a 3D mesh, but you won't have information about specularity for the material. For this matter, it is ideal to take extra pictures from different angles. You can even change the lighting if you're indoors, or come back to it on a sunny day to have better reflection references for when you get to the stage. I won't digress into the process of creating a roughness map in Substance Designer, but here's the final node graph I put together for this particular case. And as you can see, I constructed it from the other maps that we created in the previous steps. I would like to address you to two other channels that can help you understand photogrammetry and PBR reconstruction more extensively. If you have any particular questions about the process, just put it down in the comments, and I will reply to you ASAP. Thank you for watching.